when the FDA said that you had to reduce the amount of trans fats in oils, that caused an issue with soybean oil. And so the checkoff boards decided, hey, we need to fund some projects that would give us a lower saturated fat or even zero trans fat option. Given that other oils or other commodities already had a high oleic option, we funded research to breed the high oleic characteristic or hybrids into soybeans. The soybean checkoff boards were very progressive and forward thinking. When the FDA came out with that ruling that was going to take place, they were forward thinking to say, we need to fund this research now, otherwise we will lose a market share for our soybean oil if we don't come up with a better soybean oil. One of the best properties of the high oleic soybean oil, it's zero trans fat, so it's a healthy option to consume oils that are needed in our food production without that. And the other opportunity that high oleic soybeans offer is the high scorch point. It's 400 degrees scorch point. That oil is so forgiving, even me, who I don't profess to be a really good chef, I couldn't even mess it up. So I've had the opportunities to talk to a lot of people in the food industry, both domestically and abroad, as well as consumers promoting the high oleic soybean oil. And everybody loves it. They want it. We really have probably more demand than we can meet right now. We grow them partly because it doesn't take any extra effort to grow high oleic soybeans as it does commodity soybeans. You just plant them the same planters, same crop protection products, same nutrient requirements, same harvesting. You just segregate them when you harvest. So they're very easy to grow. I see high oleic soybeans as a really big opportunity to capture and increase the value of that soybean oil. And we have very strict parameters of how that in checkoff investment can be spent. Promotion, education, market development, new uses, no policy. We cannot lobby with the checkoff dollars. That's what the Growers Association is for. We're very close partners, and I guess you could say it's like a marriage. Very different roles, but partner to realize the same goals. ASA and USB, different roles, complementary missions.